Last week was the big Human Factors in Computing Systems conference, which is the largest HCI conference in the world. And it's a great place to see the latest interaction research. Many of these ideas could have a big impact on education, but there's over 300 papers and video showcases. So I've watched them all, and I wanted to highlight the best papers related to education. I'm DoctorET, and this is Ed on EdTech. In the category of new simulations, there's Looking Inside the Wires from Northwestern University that visualized the electron flow in a circuit to help students better understand how electricity works. In User-Guided Synthesis of Interactive Diagrams from Harvey Mudd College, there was an interactive spring that could be helpful for physics education. In Sketch-Based Graphs from the University of Central Florida, it allows you to handwrite equations that you see automatically graphed. Tokiko Self-Configured Surface from the University of Louisville allows you to power sensors using conductive cloth, so that you can imagine attaching them with something like Velcro. Hobbit Bench for Teaching from the University of Bordeaux enabled augmented light science experiments and allows visualizations of things that cannot be easily seen, such as waves. In the category of new tools for making, there's Peniel from Autodesk that 3D prints different types of cell phone cases that allow for interactivity. There's Light as a Creative Material by UC Berkeley that explored the role of light in clothing and buildings. The Protomold Vacuum Forming project from Keio University allows you to quickly create 3D shapes and reuse them for the next class. Electric from CMU allows you to spray an object with conductive paint and attach electrodes to turn it into an interactive surface. In the category of new body interactions, there's the skateboard pressure pad from KAIST. It automatically plays back your movements so you know how to improve. With Haptics in VR from Hasso-Plattner Institute, they trigger force feedback by directly stimulating the muscles. MakerWare from the University of Maryland College Park provides an arm warmer that you can attach sensors and outputs to. In Enswing from the Chinese Academy of Sciences in Beijing, you can move your body to make music. In the category of new video interactions, there's Visualizing Predictions study from the University of Washington that found that if people pause a video and ask questions about what will happen next, it helps to improve recall and comprehension. In Vimeo from Adobe Research, it allows virtual reality video editing directly inside the headset. Divided attention in MOOCs from the University of Pittsburgh detected distractions using your heart rate on a mobile phone. Vivo Dictionary for Video from Tsinghua University added video captions and definition finding for language learning. Action Video Synthesis from UC London allows you to turn a YouTube clip into an instrument. In the category of new privacy approaches, Data Sharing of Apps from MIT CSAIL visualizes what data is being shared with what web service, so it improves your privacy awareness. In Facebook Data Valuation from Universidad Carlos III, it shows the revenue that you're generating for Facebook, so that you have better awareness of the privacy that you are sharing with them. In the Toys That Listen study from the University of Washington, parents were concerned about toys recording children, and they didn't know that recordings were accessible to them. In the category of new interesting interactions, proximic transitions from Aarhus University mechanically moves two surfaces for sitting and standing. Ghost ID from the University of Toronto enables a capacitive touchscreen to identify the touches of different people. In the 3D tracked sphere with projector from the University of Grenoble, it makes it appear as if a 3D object is inside a globe that you can easily move. An Illuma paper from TU Dresden combines the input of an Enodo pen with embedded light displays. And in Write Large from Microsoft Research, it provides a simpler pie selection with your non-dominant hand using two fingers. In order to make this summary as short as possible, I only mentioned one of the organizations in each paper. If you want to get the full details, you'll find every paper with a link in the description below. I'd love to hear what you think is the coolest education-related paper in the comments below. And if you like this video, please give it a like. And if you want to see more videos related to education, please subscribe. Thanks very much.